This is very different from the semi-animal screwing up of the nervous forces, which, with some people, stands for willpower. It implies no strain on the nervous system, and is consequently not followed by any sense of exhaustion. The willpower, when transferred from the region of the lower mentality to the spiritual plane, becomes simply a calm and peaceful determination to retain a certain mental attitude, in spite of all temptations to the contrary, knowing that by doing so the desired role will certainly appear. The training of the will and its transference from the lower to the higher plane of our nature are among the first objects of mental science. The man is summed up in his will. Whatever he does by his own will is his own act. Whatever he does without the consent of his will is not his own act, but that of the power by which his will was coerced. But we must recognize that, on the mental plane, no other individuality can obtain control over our will unless we first allow it to do so. And it is for this reason that all legitimate use of mental science is towards the strengthening of the will, whether in ourselves or others, and bringing it under control of an enlightened reason. When the will realizes its power to deal with the first cause, it is no longer necessary for the operator to state to himself in intenso all the philosophy of its action every time he wishes to use it. But, knowing that the trained will is a tremendous spiritual force acting on the plane of first cause, he simply expresses his desire with the intention of operating on that plane,